This week on Practitioner Wired, Lego style architecture goes to the extreme with the Batcave. NASA unveils its fashion line of space robot pants. Left-handed gamers get some love on the PlayStation Vita via Resistance Burning Skies. And I thought we were supposed to hate and boo the heels in professional wrestling. All this and some MonsterCon stuffises and news this week on Practitioner Wired. Howdy, hey there, and hello. Welcome to Practitioner Wired. I'm Montez McCrary, the Practitioner, and I love to geek out about architecture, technology, video games, pro wrestling, and nerd and geek culture. Now, in case you're wondering, San Antonio MonsterCon this past weekend was awesome. And for a first-time event, I was very impressed and excited with the amount of booths and with the number of attendees and just the atmosphere. It was wonderful. I got to meet two old friends from high school who had a booth. Zombie Response Team. Got to meet some people who were in movies. I got to score some t-shirts, a zombie love storybook, some buttons, and some other great shots of pictures and video that I'll be releasing very soon. Plus, I got this new Logitech Harmony 600 remote. And basically, I got to replace this remote, this remote, this remote, and this remote. I'm really loving it, and I'm probably going to do a review on it much later. Anyways, stories. I enjoy how the Batman Arkham and Lego Batman games give me some sliver of hope of actually being the Dark Knight himself, aside from actually, winning the lottery and having the funds necessary to be Batman. Boy can dream. A pair of Lego builders decided to channel their fandom for Bruce Wayne's alter ego by making their own scale Batcave. First shown at Emerald City Comic Con, Carlisle Livingston II and Wayne, wink wink, Hussey constructed a 20,000 plus Lego brick Batcave that took them almost 6 months to finish at over 800 hours of labor over the course of 12 weeks. Now this Lego Batcave includes four motors to operate multiple features such as the rotating platform for the Batmobile, the revolving wall of bat weapons and gadgets, and even a lift for the Batplane. Man, I thought I really wanted the Lego architecture Sydney Opera House, but I think I may want this instead. Now, just need to make some room for it. Right back there. And NASA has given us so much innovation over the years, space travel and discovery, memory foam, water filters, etc. And now NASA continues to bring their technology used by astronauts back home to us mere earthly mortals by giving us these epic and amazing powered exoskeleton pants. The XI, or Z, it's spelled XI. Anyway, the XI robotic exoskeleton is a device/vehicle that's currently under development by NASA and the Florida Institute for Human and Machine Cognition. It weighs in at about 57 pounds, provides extra resistance for astronauts in space, and hopefully for paraplegics as well. The XI has four motorized joints placed at the hips and knees, along with six passive joints located up and down the leg, allowing for extra freedom of motion to move forward, backwards, side to side, diagonally, and other directions than just straight. So between my pre-orders of Black Ops 2, Assassin's Creed 3, WWE 13, I might need to find some way to put in the pre-order for this thing. Mainly because I just want some robot pants. I want some super awesome space robot pants. Now, although the hardware implementation of switchable right-handed, left-handed control configurations in gaming are lacking nowadays since the days of the Atari Lynx, many current games do have an option to reverse the left and right control layout for the benefit of the left-handed folks out there. And recently, a new patch for the PS Vita game Resistance Burning Skies will allow an option to utilize left-handed controls. Now, the game's developer, Nihilistic, who's currently focusing on the release of Call of Duty Black Ops Declassified that comes out next month, released a patch named 1.02 for their debut PS Vita game, which along with left-handed controls also features adjusted power for the mule in multiplayer, added sound effects for enemy melee attacks in multiplayer, fixed a bug with the Mauler sound effects, various bug fixes to improve the multiplayer game connection processes, launching into multiplayer game from part now bypasses several screens for a quicker start, thank god. Stat reporting to MyResistance.net enabled. Guess you want to keep track of your stats online. Improved kill tracking in multiplayer. Fixed a bug that caused the map vote details to not be received to some players. And fixed some other bugs with match bonus scores, which is also a huge godsend. Now, I just recently gave this update a try, but since I'm right-handed and took some getting used to, basically forget everything I learned about FPS games and get used to this new layout, it's very obvious that this patch is not for me. But I asked to the left-handed gamers out there with Burning Skies on their Vita, how's it playing for you? In the world of professional wrestling, a heel, or villain, or bad guy, ne'er-do-well, typically does things dastardly and despicable that makes the fans boo, yell, and shout insults in their general direction. However, in many cases, many fans still enjoy seeing these guys regardless of their attempts to gain negative heat from the crowd. One of my favorite wrestling sites, The Bleacher Report, compiled a top 10 list of the WWE's most popular and beloved heels of all time, making note of the wrestlers who received more cheers than ever and were able to transcend their role as a 100% villain. In the cases of these 10 wrestlers, they've all transcended just being the villain and were just very talented and entertaining regardless of their face or heel status. You know, the list included guys like Gorgeous George, the original heel, for being very arrogant and very regal. Current guys like CM Punk uses a straight edge lifestyle to relate to fans and both claim superiority over them. Eddie Guerrero, who took shortcuts to win, you know, I lie, I cheat, I steal. Kurt Angle's bragging about his accomplishments, especially with the 1996 Olympics and the gold medals he has. And Vince McMahon, because, well, he's a boss. Simple as that. We now patiently wait for the list of the most least popular and despised heels, which I'm pretty sure that list will be very, very long. So last week I asked, what architectural structure in another country would you like to see in person? Now my answer was the Parthenon in Greece, and I got some other answers, including the pyramids of Egypt, the Bilbao Guggenheim Museum in Spain, the Sydney Opera House, which you could just get the Lego set, and even the good old Alamo itself. Thumbs up, ladies and gentlemen. Remember the Alamo. This week's question is related to the technology story, and that is, what piece of NASA technology would you like to add to your home/daily routine? My answer is still the Zai robotic exoskeleton, mainly because I just want to be able to accomplish more labor-intensive tasks around the home and what else, and just to say I have some space robot pants, should money be no object. So what about you? Leave your comments down below and leave your answers down below. Comments and answers are the same thing. Answer below. Well, thanks for tuning in, everybody. If you like what you see here and you want to see more of what I have to offer, like this episode and subscribe to the channel. You can follow the blog at thepractitionnerd.com, and you can follow me on Twitter at practitionnerd. And you can find The Practitioner on Facebook, Google+, Tumblr, Pinterest, Instagram, and Flickr. The Practitioner Amazon store is open. Just click store on the blog and you can purchase your Amazon stuff normally, plus you get to help me out a little bit. For more detailed information on the stories reported in this week's episode, click on the individual links in the video description. So now I'll leave you guys with this quote from Lord Chesterfield, which is, you must look into other people as well as at them. So guys, remember, stay true to yourselves, stay blessed, and most of all, stay nerdy. See you guys next week.